Little Unveiled Finds for Lesson. This is a book from 500 years ago written by Liao Fan on how to use your own potential to change your destiny. So the first chapter was about his own life, how he changed himself. Because he cultivated all that is good and changed all his bad ways, he had two sons and he was mayor, and then he lived to an old age. All because he changed his karma. By karma, we mean, you know, we do good deeds, we will have good results. You know, we do bad deeds, we will end up with bad results. The second chapter was about reforming the bad ways. So you have to change your bad ways and then do all that is good. Today we are already on the third chapter. So this third chapter is about ways to cultivate goodness. After you change all the faults or the fences that you have, now we can really focus on doing all that is good. A virtuous person creates a prosperous life naturally, because you reap what you sow. But you have to differentiate what is good and what is evil, or what is merit and what is offenses. Sometimes it's kind of hard to tell. You don't know if I'm doing it right or I'm doing it wrong. There are eight pairs differentiating what's good or what's bad. First pair is real goodness and false goodness. What do I mean by real goodness or false goodness? There was a group of scholars, they went to the Zongfeng monk and asked him, what is virtue, what is goodness? And the monk said, why don't you guys tell me what is considered good? All the scholars like, oh, if you're respectful and you're nice, you're polite, that's being good. If you yell at someone, mean to someone, that's considered bad. And what did the monk say? Not necessary. And they're like, so what's the answer? So what is real goodness? And then the monk said, if your intention is to benefit the other person, even if you yell at him, that's considered goodness. Okay, so like the mom is teaching his kid by yelling or something, or punishment, that is still what? Virtue. That's still goodness. But if you're trying to flatter your boss and you're very polite, very nice, that's still considered not good. Because you're doing it for the selfish reasons. We have to discern what's real and what's false. Real is you're doing it for the benefit of others. False is when you're doing it for your own benefit. So that's the first pair. Second pair is called honest and crooked. This is kind of like the top one, right? So honest means you're sincerely wanting to help others. Some people, they do a lot of good deeds, but they want people to know. Okay, they want to have a good name. I'm a celebrity. I want people to know that I am a good person as well. So you try to flatter people. Okay, that's not really considered goodness. You want to do it because you really want to help others. And you don't want any recognition. You don't want anything in return. If you want something in return and you're just trying to flatter others, that's not real. You have to see it in your heart how good you truly are. You really want to help someone just because you really care about the other person. So that's the second pair. The third pair is hidden goodness and visible goodness. Hidden goodness when nobody knows. Sometimes we play with kids, playing game, Monopoly, whatever, we let them win. Or you lose to your friends because you want to make them happy, right? You want your friend to feel better. That's kind of hidden goodness. So sometimes you do things without people knowing. Or people accuse you of things, and then you don't talk back. And you don't try to explain yourself. You just let it be. That's called a hidden goodness. What's visible goodness? Visible goodness is everybody knows you're doing well. Everybody knows that you're virtuous. When you enjoy the fame itself, that is already the good fortune you receive. So it's best to do hidden goodness. Nobody knows. You don't want to tell anyone. You go clean the bathroom. You go do everything for other people without telling everybody that you're doing it. That's the third pair. The fourth pair is actual goodness and apparent goodness. Sometimes it appears to be good, but actually it's not, because the longer effect might not be good for the whole society. For example, Confucius had a student, his name is Zigong. At that time, the country of Lu tried to save the people that's been putting in other country as slavery. If you pay for the ransom, you will get a reward from the government. So Zigong actually paid for a lot of people the ransom and saved them back, but he didn't receive the government rewards. He didn't want them. And Confucius heard about it. What did he say? He says, that's not real goodness. Because you don't take the reward, then everybody will think, well, I'm being greedy if I take the reward. If you do that, then nobody will go try to save other people because they will be hesitant. Even if you're rich or you want to appear like you're very good, you shouldn't be doing that. You should take the reward so everyone else will be gladly, you know, giving ransom to save our people. We have to look at the longer effect, not just consider it by yourself, but think about the long-term effect for the whole society. There's another student of Confucius. His name is Zi Lu. One day he saw a man drowning, so he went and saved the man. The man was very grateful, so gave him his cow. Did Zi Lu take the cow? Yes. He took the cow. What did Confucius say? Good. Good. It's good you took the reward. Because nobody will hesitate to save other people's life because you can get rewards. So sometimes you think not taking stuff is good, but sometimes it's actually good to take the reward. You have to really think of the long-term effect of whatever you're doing, not just about yourself, but about the society as a whole. Okay, so the fifth one is called proper and improper. Sometimes we think we're doing good, but we are not. For example, if you're overly polite, is that good? No. You know, you might make other people feel uncomfortable when you're doing too much. Or the kid is very rude and you don't punish the kid, you're gonna make him worse, right? So sometimes you have to judge, you know, if this is proper or improper. There was a retired prime minister of the Ming Dynasty. He retired and went back to his village. One night, there was a drunk villager that came and insulted the prime minister. The prime minister, he says to his servant, oh, don't worry about it, just let him go because we don't want to be mean to him. A year later, that same drunken person, he did a grave crime. He was sentenced to death. When the prime minister heard about it, he felt very sad. He said, if a year ago I actually punished him and made know that he was wrong, maybe he wouldn't do such crime and now he's on death row. He felt like he was responsible. Sometimes you think being kind is proper, but it's actually improper. It takes a lot of wisdom and a lot of compassion to find out, to know for sure. The sixth is called full and half. What's full goodness and half goodness? So my favorite story, there was a lady, she's very, very poor, but she wants to donate to the temple. All she has is 2 cents. She brought the 2 cents and gave it to the abbot. This is all I have, can you please take it? The abbot was like, wow, you are so sincere. This is all you have and you're actually giving it away. So the abbot did a whole ceremony dedicating her merit for her. And she was so appreciative. A year later, she became a concubine. She became really rich. She came back to the same temple and now she has lots of money and she brought boxes of gold into the temple, gave it to the abbot. The abbot looked at the money and told his little monk, you can dedicate her merit for her. The concubine, she became very upset. She said, no, a year ago I brought you 2 cents and you did the whole ceremony for me. Now I brought all this gold and you tell the little monk to do it. So the abbot said, before you were wholehearted and sincere. Now you're very arrogant. Your heart is not the same. So your money is not worth the same. So 2 cents is full goodness. Hundreds of thousands of gold pieces is actually half goodness because of your heart. You have to know for sure what's full and what's half. And the seventh is called big and small. What's big virtue or big goodness and small goodness? Zhong Da Wei, he's a government official. One night he was brought to the underworld for judgment. When he was there, the judge asked to bring the record of all his good deeds and bad deeds to the place. The bad deeds, the record will fall to the whole courtyard. His good deed was only like a small little chopstick size. The judge asked to weigh the good deed and the bad deed. Surprisingly, the good deed, the chopstick size, would actually weigh more than the full courtyard of bad deeds. And he asked the judge, oh, I'm not even 40 years old. How come I have all these bad deeds? And the judge said, every one of your thought is a deed. Okay? Even if you didn't do it, it's already recorded. That's why it fall in the whole courtyard. Then he said, what is the one little good deed that I did? He said, oh, once the emperor wants to build a bridge, but it requires thousands of people's hard work, and you actually rose up to oppose it. That was a very good deed because, you know, you're really sincere at the time. You try to do for the benefit of the whole countrymen. So what was big, what was small, depending on how big your heart is. You know, he was really sincere in trying to help all the people. So that one good deed actually was very big. The last one is called difficult and easy. There are some things that are difficult for us to give. For example, you know, some people, they really like money. So give away money is really hard. So there was a Mr. Chen. He saw a poor man that was about to go to jail for something that he didn't do. He wants to help the poor man. So he actually gave up 10 years of his salary to save the poor person from going to jail so he doesn't have to be separated from his family. He's giving up things that's very difficult to give up. If you want to change your ways, you want to give what's most difficult for you. If you're really greedy for fame or fortune, then you should give those up. All these you can tell is not just by the appearance of what's good or what's bad. It's all on how big your heart is and how sincere you want to help all sentient beings to live a happier life. Today we talked about the 8 kinds of good deeds, and next time we're gonna talk about the second part of cultivating goodness. So that's a class for today. Thank you.
Thank you.